In the previous video, we had discussed about the working of Titan wheel, that is a impulse turbine. Now, we take up the study of reaction turbines, a brief study of reaction turbines. I told you already the differences between impulse and reaction turbines, and I said there are two very commonly used reaction turbines. One is the Francis turbine, which is a radial inward flow turbine. The flow is radial here, radial flow. I'll tell you what it is. And the other one is the Kaplan turbine, which is an example of Kaplan turbine is an axial flow reaction turbine. In this, there are again different types, which is not required for you. Anyway, these are the two turbines which are called, which are normally used as reaction turbines. We call them as reaction turbines. Now, we'll take up the Francis turbine. This Francis turbine has a runner, This runner has a number of vanes or blades, like this. Curved vanes are there, like this. Now, this runner is mounted on a shaft and it is enclosed in a volute casing. The water is supplied through here and it enters radially. That's why it is called from like this. And it flows towards the this thing. The water is guided at proper angle through guide vanes, and here it gets discharged from the this thing. Now, this pipe through which the discharge takes place, this is called as the draft tube. Draft tube. It is not necessary. Draft tube is not necessary in impulse turbines, but it is necessary here. This draft tube will be immersed in the tail race. This is the tail race. Tail race means the water in the river at the bottom. Now, the water is to be discharged here into this through this draft tube. Now, this draft tube is provided so that air will not enter into here and it doesn't cause any difficulty in the working of the turbine. So, this is called as the draft tube. There are different types of draft tubes that are used. In a reaction turbine, we have to use this thing. This is the level of water at the of the river. This is called as tail race. So this is how a Francis turbine works. Here the pressure energy of water gets converted into motion. This runner rotates due to flow of water. The runner rotates at some velocity, and this is called as a reaction turbine. Now, you don't get numericals on this. You get numericals either in Pelton wheel or in Kaplan turbine. Anyway, now in a Kaplan turbine, that's an axial flow reaction turbine. Kaplan turbine is an axial flow reaction turbine. There, the runner is like this. This is the runner. This is the shaft. Here, it will be like this. The runner will be like this, like the fan, the central hub of the fan. Here you will have blades, very big blades, usually 3 or 4 blades will be there, and water will enter like this. That's why it is called parallel to the axis of the shaft. It is called axial flow, and it gets discharged again through a draft tube. Now, the flow of water, due to the impact of flow of water, the runner rotates like this. This is called the dia of the runner. dia of the runner. The speed with which it rotates is small v. It is this thing. So this is called as a Kaplan turbine. It is a reaction, axial flow reaction turbine. These are the two reaction turbines which we have. We will take up the numerical problems on these. Numericals. We'll start numericals in this. See, I take November-December 2017 paper. Problem number 14. Question number 14 for 10 marks. A Pelton wheel develops 13,000 kilowatts. This is the power developed at 430 RPM. It has a, if the overall efficiency is 85%, that means it is 0.85 in decimals. At a head of 100 meters, h is 100 meters. Determine the following. A, discharge. So what is q? Dia of wheel. This is capital D. C, dia of jet or nozzle, they say. This is small d. Number of buckets. Number of buckets, width and depth of buckets, then assume small v as 0.46 times capital V, and coefficient of discharge Cv is equal to 0.98. Right. This is a problem on Pelton wheel. Now, first, let us find out discharge. The formula for efficiency is P divided by WQH. I have already told this to you. So it is P by WQH. In this formula, I know this. So I can get Q. The discharge can be got. So Q will be equal to P by efficiency into WH. This comes here, this goes there. Now, 13,000 divided by 0.85 into W is 9.81, because the liquid is water. H is 100 meters given. Let us substitute this and now calculate it and get the answer. (13,000, 13 followed by 3 zeros) divided by 0.85 divided by 9.81 divided by 100. Will give me 15.59, or I can take it as 15.6. Q cubic meters per second. Right, this is the discharge. Discharge is this much. Now, next what we have to do is, we have to find out the velocity of the jet. Velocity of the jet is denoted by this capital V. Capital V is velocity of jet. Of water issuing from the nozzle. Velocity of jet will be given by the formula Cv into root of 2gh. It gets that velocity, the jet gets that velocity due to this head. So Cv into root 2gh gives me the velocity of jet. So V is equal to, Cv is 0.98. It can be taken as 1. It will be generally very close to 1. If it is not given, we can take it as 1. That means we can leave it. So V is equal to, here it is given, 0.98 into root of 2 into G is 9.81 into H is 100 meters. Head is given as 100 meters. So now, 2 into 9.81 into 100 gives me 1962. Root of answer equals 44.29 into 0.98, that is 43.4 meters per second. So the jet enters the turbine with a velocity of 43.4 meters per second. Now, small v, that is velocity of wheel, linear velocity of wheel, small v is given as 0.46 capital V. If it is not given, we can take it as 0.5V. 0.5V, we can take this as 0.5V if it is not given. Here it is given. So V is equal to 0.46 into 43.4. So this answer what you have into 0.46 equals 19.96, say 20 meters per second. I can take it as 20 meters per second. So the velocity of the wheel. Next, this V, small v, is equal to pi dN by 60. Pi dN by 60 meters per second. I know V, N is given here. These are constants. So I can get D. D will be 60V divided by pi N. So 60 into 20 divided by pi into N is given as 430 RPM. So I'll get D. So 60 into 20 divided by pi divided by 430. That will be 0.88 meters. 88 meter, say 0.9 meter. That is the dia of the wheel. This capital D is dia of wheel. So you got this. Next we have to get dia of jet. Now is equal to area of jet, discharge is equal to area of jet into velocity of jet. Area of jet is pi d square by 4 into this is capital V. I know Q. Q I had got as something, no? P 13,000 divided by 0.85 divided by 9.81 divided by 100. I had got it as 15.59 cubic meters per second. So I have this is equal to pi d square, I don't know, d square by 4 into V is 43.4 meters per second, that is capital V. So I know everything except small d. So small d will be equal to four into 15.59 divided by pi into 43.4 under square root. D square will be that, so d will be this much, is equal to 0.676 meter or you can take it as 0.7 meter. Next, width of bucket is equal to 5d, 5 times small d, 5 into 0.7, that is 3.5 meter. Depth of bucket is 1.2d, that is 1.2 into 0.7, that will be 0.84 meters. Number of buckets will be capital D by 2D plus 15. So 0.9 divided by 2 into 0.7 plus 15. These are the formulae, empirical formulae. 15.64, say you cannot have 15.64, say 16 buckets. This is how it is to be solved.